As my colleagues have so expertly noted, we live in a very dangerous moment. Republican Party office holders have decided that participation in a democracy is optional. I don't want to lose sight of their latest efforts in particular. They're trying to change the rules of the game. Republicans have made it very clear that they are unhappy with the current makeup of the state Supreme Court, five Democrats and two Republicans. They have expressed their disagreement with numerous court decisions, as they have every right to do so. As I know from personal experience, when candidates I've supported have lost elections, you take a step backwards. You examine your message, your tactics, your strategies, your expenditures. You try to determine what you did wrong and what you can do better next time. Now, in the meanwhile, you accept the will of the people, of the voters, and you remind yourself of the magnificence of our democracy, that at the end of the day, the people rule, regardless of what you think. Unfortunately, that opinion is no longer a universally held one. We didn't get to this position overnight. It took many years and decades before we hit the point where some of my Republican colleagues decided that they didn't like the score of the game, so they were going to change the rules. Now, remember, it was only a decade or so ago that Governor Corbett and the Republican legislature enacted voter ID, a voter suppression tactic that was explicitly designed to help Republicans win. More dangerously, it was only a few years ago when former Representative Christush attempted to impeach multiple Supreme Court justices because he didn't like their rulings, efforts that have been continued to this day. Now, to be clear, there has never been an allegation of unethical, improper, or illegal behavior lodged against these justices. My Republican colleagues simply didn't like the way they were ruling. Indeed, this has all been made very clear in the co-sponsorship memo launched by Representative Ryan, who has relaunched the effort to impeach Supreme Court Justice Wecht. In this memo, Representative Ryan straight up admits that he wants the justice impeached because he doesn't like the decisions that Justice Wecht has made. Now, everybody knows that removal of a Supreme Court justice will never muster the two-thirds majority that it needs in the state Senate. That brings us to House Bill 38, a constitutional amendment which would change the makeup of the state Supreme Court by gerrymandering it into specific judicial districts. This will nullify Democrats' 5-2 majority and ensure that more Republicans are elected. I gotta be honest, this is like the sequel to a movie that flopped. My friends on the other side of the aisle will never move redistricting reform. So they're going to try to bring all of the disasters of gerrymandering to the state Supreme Court. They know what they're doing. They're trying to change the makeup of the Supreme Court in order to get more favorable rulings. Now, let me come back to what I said before. We didn't get here overnight, but you can draw a direct line from a few places. First, you make it harder for people who don't like you to vote. Next, you try to remove judges who disagree with you. When elections don't go your way, you say that they're illegitimate and unfair. And then you inflame mobs that kill people who are trying to guard members of Congress. Look, this is all part of a coordinated effort. Republicans don't like losing elections. Neither do Democrats. But if you need to change the makeup of the Supreme Court in order to shift the balance of power back in your favor, you are all of the activity we're talking about today, it is all related. House Bill 38 is part of a coordinated effort to undermine the decisions of voters, just like these nonsense allegations of voter fraud. Being a patriot in America means valuing voters to the point that you accept their wisdom, even if you disagree with it. What's happening now is pretty clear. One party believes in a fully functioning democracy. The other party only believes in a democracy when the voters go their way. My colleagues need to take a step back from the brink. They need to recognize that House Bill 38 is part of a dangerous attempt to dismantle our system of checks and balances and overturn seven elections that saw seven distinguished attorneys elected to the state Supreme Court. These continued efforts show them for who they really are. People who are trying to use the legislative system to chip away at the democratic rights of the voters of Pennsylvania.